Well, Kiwis kept in quarantine in Whangaparoa will today be allowed to leave. They were evacuated from the Chinese city of Wuhan, the city at the centre of the coronavirus disease outbreak. And while their time is over, other Kiwis from the Diamond Princess, the cruise ship that has been quarantined in Japan, are staring down the barrel of another 14-day stint after they get to leave the ship. For more, we're joined by Health Minister David Clark. Good morning.
Good morning, Hayley.
So have you managed to speak to the people who are leaving Whangaparoa today?
I have not directly spoken with the people who are leaving, but I understand that they generally are in good heart. As you might expect, they have been well looked after, and I want to say thank you to the health officials and the Defence Force and everybody else who's been involved in the effort to make their stay as comfortable as it could be in this situation.
And everybody who is leaving has been deemed healthy and free of the virus?
Yes, there hasn't been any case of the virus, no symptoms that would meet the test for a suspected case. So that's great, and those people will really be looking forward to reunion with their families and friends, I've no doubt.
We've got some more Kiwis, 11 Kiwis who are aboard the Diamond Princess, the cruise ship that was quarantined off Japan. The cruise ship that has been sort of called an incubator of this virus. Now, these Kiwis, if they choose to leave on the Qantas flight, the Australian flight, out of Japan to Darwin, they're facing another 14-day quarantine. Is that right?
That's right. Eight of them, I understand, are to board the flight. Two are going to stay outside New Zealand for a further 14 days, and one is not resident in New Zealand. Currently. So the eight that are coming will spend 14 days most likely in Whangaparoa in self-isolation. And, you know, we've got to do that for their sake, to keep a check on them, for their families, and also, of course, for the wider community. It's, you know, the infection rate on that ship is higher than in China. It is a precaution that we think is important for public health and safety reasons.
So what are the details of the self-isolation? What does that mean?
Self-isolation is what's normally done in public health situations like this. It's what's being done around the world. It's people keeping away from social situations. It doesn't mean they can't go for a walk around the block, but it does mean they should not invite a group of people over for dinner. They shouldn't go out to crowded spaces. And they need to keep a check on any symptoms that they may have. If they do develop a fever, then they should be in touch with Healthline. If they have any concerns, there's a Healthline set up. And they should observe good hand hygiene, cough hygiene, those things that you normally do in these situations with any kind of infectious respiratory disease.
Is that safe enough if they're coming from a ship, what you just said, is more infectious than places in China, that you're just trusting them to isolate themselves?
Those people, I would expect, will be going to Whangaparoa, sure, and they'll be in a quarantine situation.
Okay, good. What about the Kiwis who have chosen not to come back on the Qantas flight? Where are they going to go, and what's the process after that?
Well, so their process will be to spend a further 2 weeks off the ship outside of that situation. There, as everywhere, it's being assessed at the border, and people are not able to enter planes or ships if they have any symptoms of illness right now. That's being very strictly imposed, particularly by the Chinese, but also around the world. So anyone with a fever with signs of that illness would not be allowed to get on the flight. But as with everywhere, after 14 days of self-isolation, if people don't have symptoms, they're deemed safe to travel.
So it seems to have been working, the processes that the government has taken to try and protect New Zealand from this virus. There has been some criticism of the response. What do you say to people who say that we're not prepared enough?
Well, there are people who say we could be doing things differently. We are following the science, we're following the medical advice, and thus far we have not had a case of COVID-19 in New Zealand. Many, many countries have. There are others who'd say we're going too far and that, you know, we should lift restrictions. We are determined to follow the science. We're determined to make sure we're taking a health approach and a cautious approach for New Zealanders' health and safety.
Speaking of going too far, New Zealand Post have announced that they will not be accepting mail from China. Do you agree with that decision?
Look, I have not yet been, I've been alerted to that story, but I haven't received any advice on that. I'll wait till I've got some advice before I say anything more about that.
Okay, thank you so much. David Clark, the Health Minister. Thanks.